The Little Soldier. Sarah and Jamie were sitting in the shade of an old oak tree. They looked back along the rough and rutted road they'd travelled. Overhead, the sun beat down, and in the distance they could see it glittering on the green cupolas of a picture book city.
Can you hear something?
Like what?
Like someone playing a tin whistle.
It's a soldier.
Very small one.
Good day to you.
Hi.
Are you going to the city too?
Maybe.
It's a great place, the city, now the war's over. I'm going to seek my fortune there.
Wars? What wars?
Good day to you all.
Where did you come from?
You have appeared just in time to help me out.
Seems to me it's you who've just appeared.
What do you mean? How can we help you?
Well, you see that oak tree?
What about it?
It's all hollow.
Oh, yeah, it is. You're right.
You must climb up it until you find the way in.
What? All of us?
Yes. Then climb down inside and you will find a large hall with a great chest in the middle. On top of the chest sits a dog with eyes as big as mill wheels.
Down there? Inside that tree?
Yes. Lift him off and put him on this apron. Then he won't hurt you. Inside the chest, you'll find a treasure of gold coins. You may fill your knapsack with them.
How many do you want?
Oh, none at all. But beside the chest, you'll find an old tinder box. Bring me that and I'll be well rewarded.
Well, it seems I'm going to make my fortune before I even get to the city. Let's go, you two. Are you coming?
Might as well.
Coming.
You take good care of yourselves now.
We will. See you later.
Huge! Looks a bit fierce. What do we do if it attacks us?
Don't be afraid. I'll deal with him. Pass me that apron the old lady gave you.
Here.
Thanks.
Are you sure you're okay lifting that dog? It's about three times your size.
I may need some help here.
Come on, Jamie. We better give him a hand.
One, two, three.
Quick! Put him on the apron.
Oh, phew. Oh, I've never seen such a big dog.
It weighs a ton.
Hey, come and have a look inside this treasure chest.
Wowee! Gold coins, loads of them.
I'm going to be rich. I'm going to be rich. Oh, well, aren't you going to take any? I'm going to take as many as I can fit into my knapsack.
Okay, I'll take some for us.
Well, come on then. Let's go.
Aren't you forgetting something?
What's that?
The tinder box the old lady asked for.
Oh, yes. Silly me.
Is this it?
Looks a bit battered.
I'll take it. Right. Come on now. Let's go.
All right. We're coming.
There you are. I thought you were never coming. Did you get my tinderbox?
No sign of it. Never mind that. Take these gold coins instead.
Oh, but I thought I told you. I'm not interested in money. I just wanted the tinderbox. Are you sure you didn't see it?
Positive. Off you go now. We don't want any more trouble from you.
She's disappeared.
Never mind her. Hurry up. We've got to get to the city, remember?
Why wouldn't you give her the tinderbox?
If she wanted it more than the gold coins, there must have been something very precious in it. She's had her reward. Don't fret about her.
Now, do get a move on. I have to find lodgings for the night. You could lodge with me if you like. Come to think of it, you can be my servants. A man of wealth always has servants about him.
Oh, thanks a million. I just love being the underdog. Nice sofa. Pretty smart place, this.
So it should be the price I had to pay for it. That concierge wouldn't let me have an apartment without paying lots of gold coins in advance. Still, it is in the best quarter of the city.
What do we do now?
First things first, we can send out for a meal.
You mean a takeaway? Like a pizza or something? Great.
Pardon?
Don't take any notice of Jamie. So what's your plan then?
Well, I've already made my fortune. I've got a nice apartment. So the next thing on my agenda is to marry the princess.
Right. That sounds like a very good idea, doesn't it, Jamie?
Sure. How are you going to do that?
First of all, I'm going to have to go shopping for some expensive clothes. If I'm to marry the princess, I'll have to look like a wealthy man. Oh, and you two must have proper uniforms.
Great. I can't wait.
Did you bring the tinder box with you?
It's over there. Why don't we take a look inside it? It must have some fabulous jewels inside at the very least.
I'll open it.
You'll need to prise open the lid. Be careful.
OK.
Well, what's in it?
Nothing much.
What do you mean?
Looks like a piece of metal, a flint, and a bit of an old candle.
Is that all? Let me have a look. Oh.
Just a load of old dust.
Hopeless. What did the old crone want it for?
Beats me.
Now, Jamie and I will go in search of new clothes.
Sounds like fun.
You can stay and cook us some supper, as we haven't had time to send out for anything.
Huh? Why me?
Oh, and there are some dishes to wash too. Come on, Jamie.
Coming.
Dishes? That's terrific, that is. Jamie gets to go out and see the sights, and I get to do the dishes. I wonder how this tinderbox works. Maybe if I strike the flint on the metal... It's that dog again. Where did you pop up from?
What is your bidding, mistress? Your wish is my command.
Really? Well, in that case, you can start by doing all the washing up, and then you can cook a meal.
It is as good as done, mistress.
Now this is more like it. I can put my feet up at last.
Hey, something smells good. I didn't know you could cook, Sarah.
Oh, it's just a little something I rustled up.
Have a look what we bought.
Evening clothes, an opera cloak, jewel pins and everything to make me look like a wealthy man. Oh, and here are some uniforms for you two to wear.
You must have spent a fortune. Got any money left?
Not a lot.
That is a slight problem. Also, I heard in the town that the princess is kept locked up in a copper palace and sees no one.
Because they say a soothsayer said that she would marry a common soldier.
No, really?
Only 6 gold coins left. There's no way they're going to let you anywhere near the princess.
Let alone marry her.
Not good. Has anyone got any ideas?
I think I might be able to help. Dog! Help!
Goodness gracious me!
What is your bidding, mistress? Your wish is my command.
See this knapsack? You can fill it with gold coins.
It is as good as done, mistress.
When did you find him?
Oh, just hanging about. He does anything I tell him to.
So I see.
That was quick. He brought the gold coins already.
Well, that's problem number one solved. Now, what about problem number two?
You mean the princess problem?
Exactly.
I'll take care of this. Dog, bring the princess here.
That's amazing. He brought the princess and she's still asleep.
Oh, how beautiful she is.
Oh, where am I? And who are you?
I'm Cnut, princess, and I'm going to marry you.
Oh, really? How jolly. Anything would be better than being shut up in a copper palace all my life. Have you got anything to eat? I'm ravenous.
Don't they feed you at the palace?
Oh, yes, but I never feel hungry there. It's so boring. I'm never allowed to do anything or see anybody. And all because some stupid soothsayer said I would marry a common soldier. But you're not a soldier, are you?
Me? Of course not.
Well, this is fun. What shall we do now?
Why don't we have a dance? The dog can play us a tune.
Oh, goodness, what a large dog.
Would you care to dance?
Oh, I'd love to. Thank you.
Sway.
This is fun.
Open this door! In the name of the king!
Oh, no! They must have followed me here. Oh, please don't let them shut me up again. We were having such fun.
It's all right. I'll look after you.
Open this door! I arrest you in the name of the king.
Me? What have I done?
You kidnapped the princess. You'll come with us. Come.
Oh, no! Oh, they'll execute him for sure. Oh, please, please save him. Dog.
Yes, mistress.
Do something.
Like what, mistress?
Bring Cnut back here.
Your wish is my command, mistress.
Here he comes. Cnut.
Thanks for saving me. That was a tricky moment. They were going to execute me. We need to sort this mess out quickly.
Any ideas?
Sarah, can you get the dog to bring the king here?
Your wish is my command. Dog, bring the king here.
Certainly, mistress.
Put me down! How dare you? Guards! Arrest this dog! Guards! Where are my guards?
If you'll just listen to me for a moment, sire. I brought you here because I want to ask your permission to marry the princess.
You want to do what? Impossible! Who are you? Are you wealthy?
Fabulously.
Are you a prince?
No, sire.
Oh, well, I suppose that doesn't matter so much. All the princes I know are horribly poor. The main thing is, you're not a common soldier, that's for sure. How do you feel about paying for a new roof for the palace? It's leaking dreadfully.
No problem.
And can you keep the princess in the manner to which she is accustomed?
I can do better than that.
And will you pay for the wedding? It'll be horribly expensive, you know. The dress, the jewels, refurbishing the state coach, the guests, the marquis, all that tomfoolery.
Of course, sire.
It's a great waste of money, if you ask me. But the people expect it. I certainly can't afford it.
I should be delighted.
What's your name?
Allow me to introduce the Count of Millwheel to your Majesty.
Millwheel. Millwheel? Yes, the name does seem vaguely familiar. Right, you may marry my daughter. Now let me get back to the palace.
Your wish is my command.
What's so funny?
Nothing. Thanks for saying yes, Daddy.
Don't mention it. Let's just get the whole charade over and done with, shall we? How about tomorrow?
Oh, yes, please. Cnut, this is our wedding present to you.
The old tinderbox?
What would I want with that?
You'd be surprised. Take care of it. If you ever lose Dog, just strike the flint against the steel, and he will appear.
Oh.
Oh, and you better have Dog too. Dog!
What is your command, mistress?
My command is that you take Canute as your master from now on. Look after him. He's going to need you.
Consider it done.
But first, you can take Jamie and me home.
Whoa!
Where are we now? I think I've got jet lag.
Looks like a shed. It's kind of familiar.
Hey, there's that lyre Orpheus played in the underworld. And this must be Knud's tin whistle. Hey, look. A telescope. Haven't I seen that somewhere before?
Don't touch it. Don't look through it, whatever you do.
Why not?
Don't you see where we are? We're back in that old shed at the bottom of the garden. You know, where all our adventures started. You looked through that telescope and then we went...
Jamie, where are you? It's tea time.
It's Mum and it's tea time. I'm starving.
Does this mean our adventures are over?
Looks like it. Come on, race you back to the house.
The music in The Little Soldier is taken from Symphony No. 9 by Shostakovich. In the first movement, trombone, side drum and piccolo play music that sounds like a Wild West show. First, the violins take the lead. And then the cello, double bass and bassoon play the tune. In the second movement, the strings join in with a somber plodding theme, like a giant's footsteps. Oboe and clarinet join the strings to play their own tune. The third movement is fast and busy, with racing scales and spiky staccato passages. The strings play a rhythmic accompaniment, like galloping horses, while a trumpet plays a melody that sounds like Spanish flamenco music. Thank you. The fourth movement sounds like the beginning of a funeral march, with the dark sound of the trombones and tuba playing low down. The opening of the fifth and final movement is a bassoon melody which goes up and down the scale as if unsure in which direction to go. The second tune, played first by the oboe, twists and turns like snake charmer's music. The strings have their own tune, a bold march. The music turns strangely eerie as basses play the bassoon tune while, at the same time, the woodwind play a squeaky version of the march tune. These are just some of the highlights of Shostakovich's Ninth Symphony. You're bound to discover more every time you listen.